chain, all hail the chain. I'm a demon strong, Lord of hosts is his name. All hail the king, all hail the king. Our Redeemer is strong, Lord of hosts is his name. All hail the king, all hail the king. Our Redeemer is strong, Lord of hosts is his name. All hail the king, all hail the king. Our Redeemer is strong, Lord of hosts is his name. All hail the Ancient of Days and the elect.
Last time I looked around my hood, I seen the same old things. Drugs, prostitution, crack, everything you can name. Don't you know, church has been in the hoods over 50 years, and it still ain't do nothing for us. When I say us, the Hebrew Israelites, the so-called black people, we got to see what's going on. Peep the game. Don't be a victim.
Why don't you see that Christianity ain't for a black man? No. In 1619, they brought us here on slave ships. Whoa. Baptized us and turned us into Christians. Whoa. Then they put us on the auction blocks for gold and silver. Whoa. Where is our sovereignty? There is no reparation. We even built the White House, but the Euro take credit with no compensation. Whoa. Children are dying, pastors is lying. Whoa. They worship wood and stone. Yeah. Wake the people, take the blindfold off. Oh, the truth will make them free. Change me. Yeah. Cause the pastor keep taking our change, man. In the ghettos, in the hoods, I just see the same thing. 40 acres in a mule ain't enough for me. Wake up, get your mind out the chain game. I know you're tired of the same thing.
Tired of the same thing.
Things are so crazy. What can we do? They killing us slowly by attacking our food. Where's the sovereignty? Why would we just stand and hold picket signs? Trying to convince a government when they think we're out of our minds. IQ's low. We're getting sicker and sicker. Have you ever thought about the chemicals they add in our water? Why would I poison my newborn? Yeah. With needles and vaccines. The pastor knows it's true, but he don't wanna expose the crooked government.
Something gonna change,
man. Yeah. Cause the pastor keep taking our change, man. In the ghettos, in the hoods, I just see the same thing. 40 acres in a mule ain't enough for me. Wake up, get your mind out the chain gang.
Shalom, shalom. This is El Dayo from One Nation, One Power. Coming back to you, brothers and sisters out there, Jews and Gentiles alike. This morning, got bombarded with scriptures, knowing it was the Holy Spirit. Half sleep, hearing scriptures all in my head. I said, all right, let me get up and put this down on paper. Obviously, the Most High want to show some of you out there how did all of this matrix, how we in the religious matrix, basically. We all living in a religious matrix. Who put us in this religious matrix? Satan did. None of us was here in 1492. Do you guys, anybody out there know anybody that's still living that was here in 1492? No. Do any of you know anybody that's still alive, living, during the time of Antiochus Epiphanes? Are you following me out there? None of us were alive during those times. It's the point I'm trying to make. Because I need to show you how we get to where we are today. It just didn't happen overnight. Do you hear me? It just didn't happen overnight. How is it possible that the wicked are ruling the earth today and that God's people are the poor people today? Well, you can just simply read Deuteronomy chapter 28, beginning in verse 15 to 68. Those are the curses that put us at the bottom because of the sins of our forefathers. But I'm going to go further into detail today. So get your Bible. Don't believe nothing I say. A lot of you out there, majority of the world have never been taught the Bible. I'm going to say that again. Majority of the planet, I'm talking about from Europa, what you call Europe. The real name for Europe is Europa, which is the name of an African goddess. They'll never tell you that either. But majority of the world never read the Bible. If you have read the Bible, you never got the understanding of what the Bible was saying. Remember, you got to read the Bible according to Isaiah 28, 9 and 10, and Psalms 119, 104 to be able to get the understanding. You will not be able to deviate from that pattern and walk away with any understanding of what the Bible is saying, period. I won't even deal with a person as it pertains to the Bible if they don't break the Bible down like God told us to. That's why he's God. Isaiah 46 and 10, he declares the end from the beginning. That's why I serve him. That's how powerful he is. When you think about that verse, Isaiah 46 and 10, that he declares the end from the beginning, what other God that you ever came across declared that to you? That he was able to tell you what's going to happen in the end before the beginning. He already knew the ending. Oh, that make my head hurt every time I think about it. But get your Bible out. Get your King James Version Bible out. Why do I say King James Version Bible? Because the people that we're dealing with are not stupid. You dealing with some highly intelligent people. Demons are not ignorant. Demons are highly intelligent. They are not ignorant. They are highly intelligent. And you say, why? Let me break it down for you. The reason I'm telling you to get your King James Version Bible, not just because it's the closest thing to reality, is because a lot of verses have been taken out of all of the other Bibles. Get a pencil right now and get a paper. I'm going to read off some of the verses that are not in the NIV, NRSV, or New King James Version. I'm going to give you a few verses to prove to you your Bible been altered. They alter it. When we wake up and we be coming to the knowledge of the truth, they remove words. Why would you need to make a second Bible and a third Bible and a fourth Bible? Are they secretly saying that we need to adopt the Zeus version? We too stupid to interpret the first version? So they had to make alternate versions for the dummies, you know, first graders, fifth graders, tenth graders, as if the Bible itself doesn't explain itself. They know it does. They know this Bible from back. They're afraid of you knowing it. They don't want you to know it. So that's why they set up all of these ministries to teach you nonsense. Stuff that's not actually in the Bible. I'm going to start off today. Get your Bible. Don't believe nothing I say. But I'm going to show you some things today that, like I said before, the way I teach the Bible, I don't leave no room for gainsaying. I don't leave no room for you to be able to question what I show you unless you don't believe the Bible. But if you believe the Bible, you're on the right channel right now. You're listening to the right video right now. Because I'm going to show you and I'm going to break down some things for you like only I know I can. Because God gave me a gift to break it down. Now, let's go to a verse, one of the most misinterpreted verses that people like to quote when you're bringing them the truth. Go with me to 2 Peter 1:20. Go to 2 Peter 1:20. And then we're going to deal with a little bit of facts in the Bible. The Bible is full of facts, but we're going to bring out some of the facts on how do we get to where we are today. I'm going to show you. It was easy. The devil is, man, the devil, I'm glad the Most High sealed up the son of his wisdom because he put it on us with his intelligence. So 2 Peter 1:20, one of the most misinterpreted passages of scripture in the Bible. Let's go. Don't believe nothing I say. Follow along with me. This is 2 Peter 1:20. You ready? Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation. That no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation. Now, I'm going to just use a name, Joe Bob. Now, when I bring Joe Bob the truth of what the Bible is saying, Joe Bob runs to this passage of scripture and he misinterprets this passage of scripture when he says that the Bible is of no private interpretation. You know that's a lie? That's a lie. The Bible didn't say that. It said scripture, get a pencil and a paper. I'm going to teach you. Genesis 1:1 to the book of Malachi is scriptures. It's all full of prophecies. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John are gospels. Acts, 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, 1 Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, those are letters. So you have scriptures, you have the gospel, and you have letters. The New Testament is not scriptures. Are you with me? And it says there's no prophecy. The prophecies are in the scriptures. So in your church, you've been taught not to read the Old Testament. So therefore, you can't quote 2 Peter 1:20 because you don't know anything about scriptures or prophecy. And then it says it's of no private interpretation, meaning what the Bible says is what it means. What the Bible says is what it means. It's like going, pulling up. Everybody know what the word stop means, right? That's because you drove a car before. If you never drove a car before, you just drive right through the stop sign. If you got in and they didn't teach you at driver's school, but you had to learn what the word stop means. The Bible is the same way. It means what it says. It's simple. God didn't give us no a book full of parables. Christ taught on parables in the New Testament, but then he broke down the parable for you. He gave you the understanding of what he was saying. So 2 Peter 1:20 is of no private interpretation, talking about the prophecies. So today we're going to go into the prophecies. Once again, get your pencil, get your paper. You going to school. You about to learn something. You about to learn something very profound today. Now let's go. Let's start off in go to Job 9:24. Go to Job 9:24. I'm trying out a new Bible today. Go to Job 9:24. Job 9:24. And I'm going to give you the proper breakdown of what this is saying. Job 9:24. Job 9:24. Because I'm going to show you how easy it was for the devil to deceive us. I'm also going to use today, I think it's 2 Maccabees 3. Is it 2 Maccabees 3? 1 Maccabees 3:46. 1 Maccabees 3:46 to 53. We're going to use this today to back up the Bible. We're going to line them right up. It's going to line right up. We're going to put their pieces of precept that must be upon precept, line up on line, here a little and there a little. Now, Job 9:24. Let's uncover a mystery. Now, Gentiles, you can't get in your feelings. Because let's hold Job 9:24. Go to Jeremiah 16:19. Jeremiah 16:19. This is for you Gentiles. I'm bringing forth this information, not to make you feel bad, but for you to open up your eyes so that you can see what's actually going on planet Earth. Are you ready? Jeremiah 16:19. This is for the Gentiles. You've been lied to as well as the Jews. You have to come. That's the first conclusion you must come to. If you believe that you know the truth, right now, that you know the truth, you've been taught the truth, this is not for you. Because the first thing we had to do when we came into the truth was to realize everything we was taught was a lie. I had to first admit they were lies. Now I'm going to show you today that they lies. Go to Jeremiah 16:19. Gentiles, this is for you. O Lord, my strength and my fortress and my refuge in the day of affliction. The Gentiles shall come unto thee from the ends of the earth and shall say, surely our fathers have inherited lies, vanity, and things wherein there is no profit. This is Jeremiah 16:19. This is a prophecy of you Gentiles coming to God in the last days, saying everything we was told was a lie. Now I'm going to show you one of the biggest lies that you first got to endure. This is a hurdle for you. What I'm about to show you today, it's a 10-foot hurdle. But it's easy to overcome, because when we thought Christ looked a certain way, we worshiped him. We weren't racist or biased towards him. We worshiped him because we actually thought in our heart that that picture that the world has put around the world is Jesus Christ. We worshiped him. So you can't call us racist. If we found out, if you found out that your granddaddy looked different than the picture that your mama had gave you because she hated your granddaddy, what would be your reaction? You would go to mama and ask your wife you do it, right? And then you would want the real picture of your granddaddy, right? And then you would start researching about your granddaddy, right? And you'd be trying to figure out, why did they lie about granddaddy? Same principle. So now, go to Job 9:24. Let's go. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? You see the question mark? This is why I have a problem with ministries today. God is asking you a question. But in your church, if you go and ask your pastor some questions, you notice how angry he get? You notice how upset he get? You become a troublemaker simply because you asking questions. When in Job 9:24, God is asking you a question. Should you get upset? No. You should ponder this question, right? He says, somebody called the wicked, covered the face of the judges. Let's see. Let's go in our Bible and let's see what judges' faces were covered. Go to Deuteronomy 16:18. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 16:18. So these people that God called wicked covered the faces of the judges. Deuteronomy, 16:18. Deuteronomy 16:18. Are you ready? Follow along with me. Don't believe nothing I say. We are going to get down to the bottom of these people's faces being covered. Because you don't just cover somebody's face just to cover their face. You up to something. So Deuteronomy 16:18. Let's go. Judges and officers shall thy make thee in all thy gates, which the Lord thy God giveth thee throughout thy tribe. And they shall judge the people with just judgment. And they shall judge the people with just judgment. And they shall judge the people with just judgment. Now, let's go into the book of Joshua and see if we can get a more specific identity to these judges. Go to the book of Joshua, chapter 8. We precepting. Up on precept, line up on line. Joshua chapter 8. And we'll start at verse 32. Joshua chapter 8 and verse 32. Once again, Follow along with me. Don't believe nothing I say. I'm giving you your Bible. Joshua 8, 32 and 33. We're going to see who are these judges. What nation are these judges that God told them to make judges and officers? And he wrote there upon the stones a copy of the law of Moses, which he wrote in the presence of the children of Israel. You notice there were no other nations here at this time? Only the children of Israel. Let's keep reading. Verse 33. And all Israel, and their elders, and officers, and their judges stood on this side the ark, and on that side before the priests, the Levites. Who stood there? The elders. Who else? The officers. And who else? The judges. Who is this? All Israel. This is all 12 tribes. When you see it spoken, all Israel, it's letting you know that these are all 12 tribes. Where do you get the 12 tribes beginning? Over in Genesis 49. When you read Genesis 49 all the way down, you hear Jacob giving a prophecy to all 12 sons of what's going to befall them in the last days. And I'm going to deal with one of those tribes that's in there that you call today Mexicans, who are from the tribe of Issachar. And I'm going to show you that God knew just how confusing it would be in the last days to identify Issachar, but God gave a specific identifying marker for that tribe. And I'm going to break it down for you in a little while. That's right. There's no such thing as a Mexican. That's Isaiah 65:15. And you shall leave your name for a curse unto my chosen. For the Lord God shall slay thee and call his servants by another name. So all of those names in Genesis 49 were taken, and they were being given proverbs and bywords. They're being called today by other names. If the word Mexican means mixed Indian. If you ask them, they'll say, I'm a Mexican. That means mixed Indian. Who gave you guys the name Indian? Christopher Columbus did. So what was your name before Columbus? You don't know. You'll say Aztec. Well, since you said Aztec, I'm going to show you a book. See, we read, we study The Conquest of America by Tichvedan Todorov. I'm going to just show you just a little piece out of this book put together in 1984 to identify who today you call Mexicans. He's going to tell you everything that they was doing when they landed here. Came out of Africa. That's right. All of the laws they was keeping over here in the Northern Hemisphere, keeping the laws, statutes, and the commandments. How could you possibly be keeping the laws, statutes, and commandments over here when Africa is thousands and thousands of miles away? Unless you are those people. Because the law, statutes, and commandments in Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 7 and 8 was only given to the nation of Israel. Let's keep going. Now, let's get back on topic. Joshua 8, 32 and 33. We just identified that these judges and officers are the children of Israel. All of Israel. That means the children of Israel. That means all 12 tribes. So now we go back to Job 9:24. Let's go back. Because they covered these people's faces. We're dealing with the faces being covered. So now we're going back to the book of Job. Now we identify that those faces that were covered were the children of Israel. Now, I'm going to ask you a question. If I look just like you, would I have to cover your face or just change the name? Oh, man. If I look something similar to you in complexion and hair texture, I wouldn't have to change the face. I would just simply have to change the name. Are you with me? Stick with me. Now, they changed the faces. They covered the faces of the judges thereof. So they covered the faces. All right, Job 9:24. The earth is given into the hands of the wicked. So the whole earth at this time, I'm going to show you the time that this happened. This is a prophecy that is coming. It didn't actually happen because the whole earth wasn't given into the hand of a certain people to rule it yet. They still battling and fighting back here. So Job 9:24, the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. He. Now you know he a man. This is a man that covered the faces of other men. Because judges and officers, according to the Hebrew custom, was always men. So here we have a man, covering the faces of other men. If not, where and who is he? If not, where and who is he? This is at the bottom of Job 9:24. If not, where and who is he? 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 Question mark. Let's go find it. Can we go find him? Can we go find him using this literature? Now let's go ahead and find him. If not, where and who is he? Let's go find him. Let's go find this rascal. Let's go find this rascal that is guilty of covering the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? It asks you a question. Now you're supposed to go on a search. Where and who is he? Where is he and who is he? Where is he and who is he? Let's go. First Maccabees. You got to have an apocryphal. First Maccabees. Remember, this is why this you were not taught this. This is why they told you don't read this. I'm going to show you why they told you don't read this. That this is not canonical. Oh, man, if I want to keep somebody from reading something very important, all I got to do is tell them not to read it. And they believe me. They don't go out and try to find out for themselves. No, they just believe whatever they told. Is that just like a sheep? So he said, if not, where and who is he? He covered the faces. He covered the faces. He covered their faces. Now let's get the documented facts. Let's get the proof of who he is that did this and that it was responsible for this action. We have 1 Maccabees chapter 3. We're going to start at verse 46. And by the way, you need to go online and you need to type in, because I'm not doing all this work for you. Go online, type in the reign of Antiochus Epiphanes. When did his reign begin? Because the Bible calls him a wicked root. That's right. Over in 1 Maccabees, when it gets started, it tells you that Alexander the Great, they call him the Great, when he began to reign around 330, 333 B.C., he began to reign in the earth. I said about 330, 333 B.C., around that time frame. He was the first to rule over Greece. And then after him came out a wicked root, which was Antiochus, surname Epiphanes. Let's see what Antiochus, the wicked root, began to do when he was ruling on the earth. Now remember, God prophesied in Job 9:24 that the earth will be given into the hands of the wicked, and the first thing the wicked would do was cover the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? Where and who is he? Let's go find out who he is. 1 Maccabees 3:46. Wherefore the Israelites. It's why I'm saying Israelites. Talking about all 12 tribes, the children of Israel, the sons and daughters of Jacob, whereof the Israelites assembled themselves together and came to Massah over against Jerusalem. For in Massah was the place where they prayed aforetime in Israel. It was a place of prayer. They all assembled to the place of prayer. Verse 47, then they fasted that day and put on sackcloth, and cast ashes upon their heads, and rent their clothes. Verse 48. And laid open the book of the law, the Old Testament, the scriptures, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy, the book of the law, the book of the law, the Bible, at this time, wherein the heathen had sought to paint the likeness of their images. This is 1 Maccabees 3:48. 1 Maccabees 3:48, you want to take a pen or a pencil and write it right next to Job 9:24. For the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. If not, wherein, who is it? He covered the faces of the judges thereof. Here is the very act of them covering the faces. This is it right here. 1 Maccabees 3:48. They did what Job 9:24 said they would do, was cover their faces. Let me read it again. 1 Maccabees 3:48. And laid open the book of the law, wherein the heathen had sought to paint the likeness of their images. They brought also the priest's garments and the first fruits and the tithes and the Nazarites they stirred up, who had accomplished their days. Then cried they with a loud voice toward heaven, saying, what shall we do with these? And whether shall we carry them away? This is 1 Maccabees 3:50. The Israelites asked the question after they caught the heathen painting the likeness of their pictures in the Bible. They said, what shall we do with these? And where shall we go to take them away? Meaning, how are we going to destroy them? Because they are attempting to paint their faces, to paint their image in our book. The heathen are the Gentiles. The Gentiles right here are making a move to put themselves into the Bible as the people of God. Isaiah 46:10, God says he declares the end from the beginning. Now, you can get all puffed up and angry with the word of God. It's because you believe in a lie. We trying to rip that lie out of you right now, ma'am. We trying to rip that lie out of you right now, sir. So if you sit tight, buckle up, you can make it through this. I know it's painful right now, especially for you Gentiles, to come to the realization that your ancestors are responsible for altering the pictures of the real people of God in your Bible. And it's still in your Bibles today. When you open, that's how they deceived you. They just put paintings in the Bible. The Bible did never have images in it. The Israelites were forbidden from making images. This is the first instance of images being put in the Bible, and it's not the people of God putting their images in the Bible. These are the Gentiles, are the heathen nation, putting this in the Bible. Who is ruling right here? The Romans. The Romans are the ones responsible. If not, where and who is he? Let's identify. Romans. Antiochus Epiphanes. They're putting their pictures in the Bible. Look up online the timeline of the reign of Antiochus Epiphanes on the earth, and you'll know exactly when they started to alter the pictures in the Bible and to paint their picture in the Bible. Now, if they looked just like the Israelites, they wouldn't have had to do that. I told you, all they would have to do is change the names. So these heathen didn't look nothing like the Israelites. They looked opposite of the Israelites. Because when the Israelites seen the heathen paint their pictures in their Bible, they got so upset, they were trying to figure out how they're going to destroy and get them out of there. This caused the Maccabean War or Maccabean Revolt. Today, you look at your Bible and you don't even know that people lost their lives over those images that are in your Bible today. Well, I'm here today to bring you that revelation and give you that understanding and to maybe bring you out of the matrix that you've been trapped in. Because you believe somebody is somebody that's not, and you believe the other people are not. See how they did it? They got you. This whole earth is in confusion. All because you won't read. Or you won't sit up under a teacher that can bring you the understanding. You'd rather stay in darkness and in ignorance and follow a false lie. Revelation 21:8. Behold, God says he's going to put all liars into the lake of fire. I'm bringing you the truth. I don't got time to be practicing lie. Why? I'm not going into the lake of fire. I'm going to bring you the truth, 100% true. Can you handle it? If you can't, turn this channel. Go to somebody that's going to lie to you. We trying to get to the kingdom of heaven that's coming to the earth. But first, you got to know how Christ looked. If you don't know how Christ looked now, we're going to hit on that. You worshiping and serving another image. That's not even the one you praying. How that look, you trying to pray to Christ, and you got an image of some other guy in your head. Is Christ happy with that? That's like a guy talking to a woman and calling her another name. What does she do? Does she get mad? Yes, she do. All right. So here we have where and who is he. We just identified. We identified who they were that changed, put their pictures in the Bible. Now, if they put their pictures in the Bible, wouldn't it be written somewhere in the Bible? Because they couldn't just put themselves in the Bible and then not play like they're the people of God. Wouldn't that be in the Bible? Wouldn't that be in the Bible? The Bible already told us that they covered the faces of the original people of God. So if they put their face in the Bible, now they got to pretend like they are God's people. Wouldn't it be in the Bible? Because you can't just put your face in there and not act like you are the people. You got to come, a whole gimmick got to come out of that. Because if you're living like the devil and in public and playing like you God's people, people are going to catch on. So would it be in the Bible where God said, why did you take my Bible in your mouth? Why are you preaching from my book? Because it don't belong to you. Let's go. Psalms. Go to Psalms. Chapter 50. Psalms. Chapter 50. Let's prove it. Psalms. Chapter 50. Don't believe nothing I say. This is your Bible. Psalms 50. You know that one you got at home sitting on the shelf? Psalms chapter 50. Psalms chapter 50. Where we want? Verse 16. Psalms 50 and 16. You want to precept it. Take your pen and paper. Take your pen, and write Job 9:24. For the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? So we have one prophecy that they will cover the faces of the judges, the real people of God. Now, they got to do something else. They can't just put their picture there. They got to now pretend to be the people of God. Let's go. Psalms 50 and 16. But unto the wicked, God said. But unto the wicked, God said. Job 9:24. The earth is given into the hands of the wicked. Psalms 50 and 16. But unto the wicked, God said. First, God said they was going to take over the earth. And now God talking to the wicked. But unto the wicked, God said, what hast thou to do to declare my statutes, or that thou shouldest take my covenant in thy mouth? This is Psalms 50 and 16. God asking those same wicked people that put their face in the Bible, who are you to try to teach my Bible? I didn't give it to you. Why? You got to go back to Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 7 and 8, where God gave the law, statutes, and commandments. Go there. Go there. This is what God's saying. Who are you to take my covenant in your mouth? You are the wicked. I didn't give you my covenant. No, we're going to prove it. Let's see who the covenant was given to. But first, we want to deal with. But unto the wicked, God said, what is thou to do to declare my statutes, or that thou shouldest take my covenant in thy mouth? Go to Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 7 and 8. Deuteronomy 4. Let's prove it. I operate in facts. Deuteronomy chapter 4. Don't believe nothing I say. Go with me. Deuteronomy chapter 4. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 7 and 8. For what nation is there so great, who have God so nigh unto them, as the Lord our God is in all things that we call upon him for? And what nation is there so great that has statutes and judgments so righteous as all this law which I set before you this day? God is telling the Israelites, that there is no other nation on earth like you, because I gave you laws, statutes, and commandments. All the other nations on the earth at this time were worshiping wood and stone. They had images. They had no moral laws. Where did the moral laws come from? The book of Leviticus. Who we give the book of Leviticus to? The Israelites. That's right, the children of Israel. He didn't give it to the Canaanites. He didn't give it to the Perizzites. He didn't give it to the Hivites. He didn't give it to the Sodomites. He didn't give it to the Perizzites. He didn't give it to no other nation. This is why he says in Psalms 50:16 to the wicked, what are you doing trying to declare my statutes and my judgments? I didn't give them to you. Let's prove this even further. Go to Isaiah. What do we want? We want Isaiah. Is it 40? Isaiah 40. Go to Isaiah 40. Go to Isaiah 40:17. Isaiah 40:17. Let's get deeper into why God said that to the wicked. He didn't give them his law, statutes, and commandments, but they took it in their mouth. And what they do? They twisted it. You don't have to keep God's laws now. That's the heathen. The heathen are the children today, the descendants of those of Antiochus, the Romans, that put their pictures in the Bible, and then Psalms 50:16, they started trying to teach the Bible, but the first thing they did was teach that God's laws are done away with. God never told you his laws were done away with. See what the heathen did? They started trying to teach something that wasn't given to them. So they don't know this Bible. I'm teaching you the Bible because it's in my DNA. You see in the Bible for the first time in your life. Go to Isaiah 40:17. Isaiah 40:17. This is why God says this. Isaiah 40:17. Watch. This is why God says this. We're going to start at Isaiah 40:17, and we're going to read down. We're going to see why God say this. All nations before him are as nothing. I thought God loved everybody. See, you got a misinterpretation of what the Bible's saying. He just said in Isaiah 40:17, all scripture and prophecy is of no private interpretation. So now I'm reading this. He said, all nations before him are as nothing. You know what you just did? You said, but. God just told you all other nations are nothing. Why did he say they nothing? Because he didn't give them no laws, statutes, and commandments. He didn't give them morality. He gave it to the Israelites. But the Israelites were supposed to take it and teach the rest of the world, according to Isaiah 49:6. So the reason we are in all this confusion on the planet right now is because the children of the descendants of the Romans are trying to teach a book that was never given to them, Psalms 40:16. What have you to do to take my covenant in your mouth? Why you put my Bible in your mouth? Why you put my words in your mouth? You don't know how to teach my book, Psalms 50:16. This is what it's saying. But God said unto the wicked, who gave you the law, statutes, and commandments? I didn't give them to you. If I didn't give them to you, you don't know nothing about them. You don't know how to interpret the book. That's what God's saying. Psalms 50:16. Now in Isaiah 40:17, he says, all nations before him are as nothing, and they are counted to him less than nothing and vanity. Why? Verse 18. To whom then will you liken God? Question mark. And now he's breaking it down to you why he's saying all the other nations are nothing, because you don't know him. You never met him. You just now hearing that he's the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You thought he was the God of the whole world. He never told you that. He said, I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, a bloodline. And then he says, to whom will you liken God? He asking the question to the other nations. What you going to liken me to? And then he's going to tell you what you're going to liken him to. Or what likeness will you compare unto him? Question mark. These two question marks. See why you're supposed to ask questions? But when you go to your pastor, he get upset because you ask him a question, and then you become a nuisance, and they got to move you out to church because now you bothering people because you simply asking a question. God just asked you two more questions. To whom then will you liken God? Or what likeness will you compare unto him? Verse 19, now he's going to tell you. The workmen melted the graven image. Now he's telling the other nations, how you going to liken God? How you going to subscribe to him? He said, the first thing you other nations going to do, you're going to make a graven image. Verse 19, the workmen melted a graven image, and the goldsmith spread it over with gold and cast its silver chains. Verse 20, he that is so impoverished that he has no oblation chooses a tree that will not rot. He seeketh unto him a cunning workman to prepare a graven image that shall not be moved. Stop. You can keep reading down. God says, all you other nations, you nothing to him because you're going to liken him to a tree. You're going to liken him to a stump. You're going to make an image of God, and you're going to call it God, and you're going to say it's God. And then when God sent a real prophet to you to tell you that God already declared the end from the beginning, that picture you got on your wall is not him. That picture you carry in your wallet is not him. This is what he's saying. This is why all other nations are as nothing to him, because he said the first thing you guys going to do, you're going to go make a graven image and say it's him when it's not him. And I'm here today to let you know it's not him. I just showed you that the heathen in 1 Maccabees chapter 3 verse 46 and down put their images in the Bible. I just showed you in Psalm 50 and 16 that God said, what do you heathen got to do with my covenant? Putting it in your mouth. Because you wasn't there when Moses took the blood of the covenant in the book of Exodus and sprinkled it on the people. Exodus chapter 23, he sprinkled the blood on the children of Israel. You wasn't there in Amos 3 and 1. You only of all of the families of the earth have I known. Therefore, I'm going to punish you for all your iniquities. That's why we on the bottom, because we being punished for all of our iniquities. So in Psalms 50 and 16, once again, what do the wicked got to do by taking my covenant in your mouth? You don't know nothing about the covenant. That's why it's so much confusion. You don't know nothing about the covenant. You teaching people not to keep the laws of God when God teaching his people to come back to the laws of God. Because in Hebrews 8 through 13, he going to write those laws on the tables and the contents of our heart. What type of person would you be saying that you love God, you desire God, but God looks like this stick, or God look like this picture? God is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and he hate images. He hate graven images. Why? You going to worship the image more than you do the real God. I hope I'm getting to somebody out there. You worshiping a picture or an image more than you do to God. You going to that and talking to that when you're supposed to close your eyes and talk to the unseen God. See, it's hard to use faith to talk to somebody you don't see. So that's why you got to set up an image, because now you make God more real to you and you make him more close to you, not knowing that God is a spirit and that he's everywhere. Your graven image only in your bedroom. It's only in your car or in your bumper. God is everywhere. He's the God in the heavens, on the earth, and under the earth. And you can call upon him, and he's right on time. So let's continue. Now they covered their faces. They painted the images in the Bible. Did they stop putting images in the Bible? That's how they deceived you. Because you can't get one scripture in the Bible to back up these pictures. Hello. You can't get one scripture out of the Bible to back up these pictures. This is what I'm trying to show you. You've been lied to. The heathen, 1 Maccabees 3, 46 down to 49, they painted the likeness of their pictures in the Bible. These Romans, look at them. These are the Romans. The Romans put their pictures in the Bible because they knew you wouldn't read the Bible. They knew that the whole, that's why you got the television. They steadily bombard us with pictures and images. And you believe the pictures and the images that they give us. You don't read to see if this is actually in the Bible. Does the Bible say that these are the people of God? That the Romans are the people of God? Let's get some more. It's more. This book is full of Romans. See these Romans? You know how you know these Romans? Look at the dress. Look at the dress. The Romans always dressed half naked. The men always walked around with barely any clothes on. These are Romans. These are the heathen the Bible telling you about. The heathen sought to paint the likeness of their images in our book. Hey, y'all, right in your face. A quick, easy teaching that you've been deceived. So you walk around every day and you say that don't matter. Go to Revelation 13. You've been so deceived that you say that don't matter. Do God hate images? Do the God of the Bible hate images? And then you put it in his book? How mad you think he is? Huh? Before I go there, go to Psalms 96:5. Psalms 96:5. Let's prove to you that all of the gods of the nations are idols. Images. Psalms 96:5. For all the gods of the nations are idols. For all the gods of the nations are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. So Psalms 96:5 goes along with Isaiah 40:17, 18, 19, and 20, that God said you was going to turn around and liken him to idols, to images. That's why he said all nations to him are nothing, because you worshiping a false image. Let's see if that's going to get you in the end. You sitting there saying it don't matter. Let's see what God say if you're going to heaven. Because you're trying to get there. I know you are. You're trying to get to the kingdom of heaven coming to the earth. Now let's go to Revelation 13, verse 14. This is why this says this. And deceived them that dwell upon the earth. This is Revelation 13 and 14. Of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell upon the earth that they should make an image to the beast which had the wound by a sword and did live. Verse 15. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Now you got to know history. When did the Roman Empire fall? When did it fall? It said that right here in verse 14, it says that they should make an image to the beast which had the wound by a sword and then live. When did Rome get wounded? In 193 AD. It fell under Septimius Severus. When did it resurrect? In 1453, during the Renaissance period. You trying to find out where the Romans at? They back in power. They just back in power under different names. Come on up out of here. They back in power. And they made an image unto the beast. They made an image unto the beast. God said that all of the gods of the nations are idols. They made an image to the beast. And they put it in your Bible. Wake up. Wake up. The real Christ is coming. And who are you worshiping? An idol. It's called idolatry. Go to Revelation 21 and 8 right fast. I'm trying to save somebody's soul. Revelation 21 and 8. Revelation 21 and 8. Revelation 21 and 8. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and idolaters. Idolatry is the worship of an image as God. And idolaters, I'm trying to save your soul, and idolaters in all lives shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Everybody that's practicing idolatry is called idolaters. You worship, this is why they put this in the book. These pictures were never supposed to be in the Bible. This is idolatry. We have raw idolatry in your Bible right now, and you worshiping it. Is the devil cold? I'm trying to bring you out of the matrix. Wake up. I'm trying to save your soul. They put those pictures there because they knew that they had to change the real image of the real people of God into something that wasn't real. The heathen, 1 Maccabees 3, 46 down, 48, put the image of the pictures in there. Job 9:24, the earth was been given into the hands of the wicked. If not, where and who is he? He covered the faces of the judges thereof. Psalms 50 and 16, what are you to do to take my covenant in your mouth, wicked? Heathen, the heathen, claiming to be God's chosen people. Paya! I just broke it down for you. Now, real fast, for all you so-called Mexicans, what's in this book that they know that you don't know? You thinking that you are a Mexican. This is page 210. Page 210. The Aztecs. He's putting all the Mexicans under the Aztecs. The Aztecs are none other than one of the lost tribes of Israel. The first chapter of his history opens with this assertion. Because of their nature, we could almost affirm that they are Jews and Hebrew people. And I believe that I would not be committing a great error if I were to state this fact. It's a fact. You so-called Mexicans are Hebrew. You are Jew. Come on up out of here. Considering their way of life, their ceremonies, their rites and superstitions, their omens and false dealings, so related to the characteristics of the Jews. When they landed here, they were watching them practicing the laws, statutes, and the commandments of the Most High God, and they can only conclude that these people are the bloodline descendants of the children of Israel, one of the 12 tribes spoken of in Genesis 49, that Issachar shall be a strong ass couched down between two burdens. He saw that the land was pleasant. He saw that the land was pleasant. An ass is a donkey, is a barrow. You need to go read Genesis 49, so-called Issachar, because your whole, he put a barrow in there. If I go to Mexico tomorrow and visit, they're going to have people taking pictures of barrows. The barrow is your, it's on your flag. The barrow is worshipped in Mexico. Why are you going to be couched down between two asses? That's called siesta. The man sitting down with the hat on his head. Do they see that the land is pleasant? He bowed his back and he became a servant. He went into slavery. You still see that the land is pleasant. Who out there cutting the trees? Who out there doing the grass? Who out there picking up the pine needles? Wake up, Issachar. May the Most High bless this message. May somebody's soul be saved. We have to get rid of all images. You cannot worship an image of who you think is God, but in reality, it's not God. It's going to get you in trouble with God. Shalom.
It's your boy. Yeah, it's Kiyat. It's just like the heritage music. Take one walk in the hood and show you how the curse is all over my people, man.
Come on home with me, where the blocks are messed up. Crack streets, cops are messed up. Crack fiends, cops arrest us. No probable cause, many like to test us. Come home with me, where people look like each other. They don't care, man, they fight each other. Over bright G colors, Crips and Bloods, yo, they smite each other. Over flags, they don't like each other. Come on home with me.
where people get shot every day. Blood spill on the block where they stay, on the block where they play. Double dutch and hopscotch down the way. Hebrews, you make it hot every day. Come on home with me. On every block there's a church. People search for the truth and it hurts. The same day they go to the liquor store, get drunk and it's worse. They slump, know I did every curse. Come on home with me. Where we can get garbage for cheap. We don't care cause that's all we eat. Chinese food everywhere as far as the eyes can see. Chinese, it's all about greed. Come on home with me. To where the doors hang over hinges. Drunk parents, man, they hang over bitches. Kids scattered around. Look at you like this ain't your business. No wonder why I hang on my fridges. Come on home with me. When Sean Bell got killed like an animal, 50 shots will quickly dismantle you. That's how they handle you. They let you bleed, they won't even bandage you. Stallone style, quick to just ram with you. Come on home with me. Israel, sing along with me. Praise Yah, walk along with him. The one that's gonna bring us home from our captivity. He is saying, just come home with me. So come home with me.
Scattered to four corners, chattel by slave owners. Handled like savage monsters, the broken promise hunts. Hated on with prominence in this mental piranha pit. Analyze and ponder this to see how thick the drama is. In a realm where they breed replicants like Blade Runner. Overwhelmed, spiteful rulers, pursuers like game hunters. Smooth maneuvers like MacGyver. Prey moves remain under the radar of the beast. Who tames and slays number. But people lost and hidden, too in love with the forbidden. Before I enter, leaves me smitten from cops to past lynching. 80% of prisons known for much dissension. Minds held in suspension by delusions of the system. Crack cells to chrome in disorderly homes. See the sickest skills honed in these criminal zones. The blessings and the curses of the Israelite nation. And the latter's what we face in daily hood situation.
Look what they gave us, how they made us, how they played us. We under curses, can't no man or woman save us. Look how they slaved us, shackled and chained and hanged and maimed us. But if we lay the blame, we gotta blame us. We lead a sickle cell and STDs, diabetes, and new cases of HIV. What's even worse, we even kill each other. We kill our own brother. Don't own a block, but kill a brother for the wrong color. The forsaken, the hidden nation. Got captured up and taken by these savages and pagans. Cause what about Oscar Grant? And what about G. Will? And what about Sean Bell? And what about Emmett Till? This is Israel. That means this is real. Too much going on up in this world to keep your lips sealed. I let the clip spill. If it's Yah's will to put me on a battlefield and kill, then it was Yah's will. And I take orders like a good soldier. The overseers that oppose us will get smoked just like some good Doja. It's me against the world like Pac said. Until Yah pick us up and take us home just like the ox said.